What's up, New Worlder? Pink Woodpecker here, and we are back with 10 more tips that are absolutely crucial for being successful in New World. So stay tuned. Now, if you haven't watched my first video where I give out 15 quick tips in New World, I would highly suggest checking that out because this is kind of a continuation of some of the elements I touch on in that video as well. Anyways, without further ado, let's jump into it. So, tip number one is speed rolls, but this time it's version 2. In my first video, I show you how to speed roll using two different weapons, but I'm here to actually tell you that you don't need two different weapons and you can just use the first mechanic that you learned in New World, which is sheathing and unsheathing your weapon. So if you do that at the end of your rolling animation, then it won't have your character do that awkward stop before you continue moving if you are running. Tip number two, and this is arguably the most important tip. Whenever you get a piece of equipment or a weapon that is a higher gear score of whatever you're currently using, just go ahead and equip it. You don't have to use it, just go ahead and equip it. You can equip it and then unequip it right afterwards. Why do you do this? Well, when you do that, you're actually recording your highest gear score for that slot. So when the game decides that you're extra lucky for a drop, you have the potential to receive a drop that is equal to or slightly higher than whatever your highest recorded gear score for that slot is. This is called watermarking. A lot of people don't know about this, so whenever you get an item or a weapon, just go ahead and equip it and then unequip it, even if you don't plan on using it, because it's going to record that higher gear score. Tip number three, you don't actually have to hold on to all your materials while you're in a settlement. I know when I first started playing, I thought I had to pull things out of storage and then go to a specific working station in order to be able to use those resources, but that's actually not the case. If you put everything in your storage in the settlement, you'll be able to access it from anywhere inside the settlement. This includes any working station, as well as town board quests if you have to turn in like rawhide or resources or potions. You can pull those things directly from your settlement inventory. Tip number four, resource locations, but on a pro level. Now, there are two extremely helpful sites. There's the New World Map Genie and the New World Map. Personally, I prefer the New World Map because it seems slightly more accurate. This map is like a conglomerate of all resource locations, elite locations, chest locations, enemy locations, I mean pretty much everything that you can think of. If you haven't discovered it, it'll show you exactly where it is. Now, if you don't want to do that and you want to be a hardcore adventurer and track your own course, then obviously you can just forget that this exists. Either way, if you're a hardcore harvester or a crafter and you want to know where the best, you know, mining sites are, then this site or sites are going to give it to you. Tip number five, kind of going along with the theme of, hey, I don't want to use that external source, there's still a lot of helpful tools for the internal map in the game. First, there's the Easy Quest Finder. Now you can click over here to your quests, and right there it's going to give you a drop down list of everything you've picked up so far. If you're wondering where the heck on the map is this quest, you can click on it and it'll take you directly there, centered on your screen, which is super convenient. You can also sort the order of your quests. You can sort it by distance, you can sort it by difficulty, you can sort it by the territory that it's found in, or you can sort it by the type. So either a main quest, a side quest, a faction quest, or a town quest. Tip number six, still on the topic of maps, don't forget to use waypoints. Now there can be some tricky bends and turns in New World. There's cliffs, there's mountains, sometimes you can go over them, sometimes you can jump off of them to quickly traverse the map, but sometimes you can't. So using waypoints to kind of keep your character on track if you're going somewhere far, if you're trying to avoid a mountain or avoid a cliff, can be extremely helpful. You can place them on your map by right clicking and simply remove them off the map by right clicking that same waypoint. I like to use these when I'm on mining runs because it keeps me oriented a little bit easier to the next node I'm trying to get to. Speaking of which, I will be dropping a mining guide very shortly on one of my favorite spots, so be sure to be on the lookout for that in the future. Tip number seven is all about increasing your encumbrance. First and foremost, you need to do this as soon as physically freaking possible. Now, there's a quest that gives one to you, but it's kind of lame, and it doesn't happen soon enough, in my opinion. I personally feel like I'm encumbered pretty much all the time, so having this earlier is better than later, if you ask me. First things first, you have to sign up with a faction. Once you do, you have to get to 1,000 faction points and buy a minor rune of holding. Once you have one of those, you can head over to an outfitting station and craft yourself a satchel. This uses 45 coarse leather, 25 cloth, 10 iron ingots, and the rune I mentioned before. Once you craft it and equip one of these bad boys, it'll expand your encumbrance by 100, which is incredible. Tip number 8. You can actually calculate the perfect number of encumbrance when you are dropping stuff, and not a lot of people know this. And there's a pretty easy way to do it, so let me show you how. Now, New World is full of slider bars that you can use in crafting, you can use in dropping items, you can use it in trading, if you're splitting a stack, you name it. But you can also just type the number that you want in the box. Just erase it and type whatever number you need. And as you're typing, or if you're still using the slider bar, in the top right corner of your inventory screen, it's going to actively update your inventory weight. So you can very quickly get to that perfect magic number of your encumbrance if you're trying to drop stuff so you can fast travel or whatever you were doing. Tip number 9. This might seem extremely random, but it is very easy to forget. Just go ahead and do yourself a favor and craft yourself a bunch of coarse leather. Now, why am I saying this? If you're gonna be crafting in any capacity in New World, just get a lot of this up front, because coarse leather is used in practically everything, even late game items. So if you're avoiding fighting animals or you're skipping over skinning your prey, you're gonna be hurting later on if you try crafting anything in the game. Tip number 10, let's talk about character attributes for just a quick second here. So if you go to that screen, you'll see from top down, you have strength, dexterity, intelligence, focus, and constitution. But what the game does not tell you is that your strength will actually impact your mining ability, how fast you can mine it, your encumbrance. Dexterity impacts your skinning speed. Intelligence impacts your harvesting speed. Focus impacts your fishing, and constitution impacts your logging. Now, I'm not saying that if you're going to be a harvester, then you need to max out your intelligence. No, that's not what I'm saying at all. What I am saying is that you need to be mindful of certain items that you pick up, especially if they're green, blue, or purple. The reason for that is because many of those items will give a boost to your strength, or your dex, or your intelligence, or your focus, or your constitution. So if you know, for example, that you're going to be mining, right, and you're very close to getting to this first threshold of a mining buff, right, 10% mining speed increase, which is pretty good, then you can equip those items which specifically buff your strength, since you know that you're going to be mining, so that you can receive this perk. So when you get items like that, you might want to hold on to them. Don't just salvage them immediately. And I do honestly mention that in my last video, so please forgive me. This is something I learned recently myself, but this can just help you in the long run if you want to be a hardcore crafter, miner, harvester, you name it. So that wraps up today's video. I hope you learned something out of it in these 10 quick tips for New World. If you did, honestly, it'd be pretty freaking sweet if you could hit that subscribe button or the like button, whichever way you please. Either way, I hope you have a wonderful day or night whenever you're watching this video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace.